Hi guys, welcome back to the Cypress Quick Tip series. So in today's video, I'm going to share another quick tip with you where I'll tell you an effective way to eliminate delays in Cypress test automation. So let's say we have a website. So there's a demo website by Lambda Test, and we have a text box present on the page, right? So if you have a text box present on a page, let's say you want to enter text, how do we enter? We enter it one by one. Let's say I want to enter test automation in Cypress using JS. So it will be one by one, right? But it is taking time to enter your text. But let's say if I want to avoid this delay, if I want to avoid this one and improve the performance of my test execution and improve the speed also, so how I can do that? So in Cypress, we can do it by using delay option. So passing delay 0 in your type command will actually optimize your test execution speed, and it will also improve your overall efficiency. So let's check our code and see how it works, right? So this is a sample code which I have already written. So I'm opening a website which is this one, which is the same demo website, and inside that I am entering the text in the text box. So this is using the type command. I'm entering the text box. I'm entering the text in that text box. So let's run this test and see how it works. So first scenario, I will not pass the delay option. First of all, we'll see how our text is entered without passing delay option. So that is a standard way. So it is getting entered one by one, right? Now the second thing is, if we pass delay 0 and if we do not pass a type text like this. So in the second case, we are passing delay 0. That means our text would be entered in single action only. It will not be entered one by one, right? So by default, the delay is 10 millisecond, but we can again change it by adding the option over here in the type command only. We can change the delay to 0, and it will actually speed up your execution and it will enter all the text in a single action. So let's see. Let's run it and see. So you see how fast it got entered. So this is my 537 millisecond. It took 537 milliseconds to run. Let's see for the first one how much time it takes. So let's comment the last line and rerun our test case, and we'll see. We'll compare both the execution speed, right? So you see, without delay 0, it is taking 979, but with delay 0, it is taking 500 something millisecond. So over here, we can see for this quick thing also, only for this much text also, there's a huge difference. There's a difference of around 300 milliseconds. And when you have websites where you have to enter huge paragraph, so just imagine how it is going to improve your efficiency. Right, so this can also be asked in your interview question, how you can improve the efficiency, and it is also one of the way to improve efficiency and optimize your test execution speed. Right, so I have one more example. So this was just a text form, but what if we have a big paragraph to enter? So there is a website which is Word Counter, in which actually you can count the words. So let's enter the text over here. So let's say we have the same text, we have a paragraph over here. So I'm entering any some random text just to show you the execution speed and if we enter this much text. So I am passing 476 characters in the text box, and we'll see if we use delay 0, what is the outcome, what is the execution speed, and if we do not pass delay 0, so what will be your execution speed, right? In this way, we can actually check all the scenarios. We checked for basic input box where we entered the text and we saw a difference of 300 milliseconds. And over here also, for the big paragraph, if you have something like this in which you have to enter a big lot of text in a paragraph, so we'll see that scenario as well. So let's go to the code and see this one. I will just copy the same test over here because the template is already defined. We will just change our web locator and then the web application name. So zero delay, I will write over here test case 2, right? So let me copy the URL. So this is my URL. Let's change the URL in thinking test case and then find the locator for this one. So I'll just do inspect element and find the locator. I can see over here there is ID, and let's see if it is There is single value with the same ID. Yes, there is single value, and because it is getting highlighted and it says one of one. So I'll use this one. So in cy.get, I'm using the locator box. And then what I'll do, I'll just copy the same text because this is huge text and I can just copy this one. Because in this scenario, earlier we saw for a small piece of text, but over here it's a big chunk of text which we can see. And in paragraph, we can see for a paragraph kind of case, right? So let's run our test case and see what is the execution time and how long it takes. So let's go back and let's reselect our test case. So let's see now how long it takes. My second test case is getting run, and you can see one by one it is entering the text on the page. And over here we can see the execution speed. So it's 0.12, right? So now over here we can see this is the execution is 12 seconds. And if I go back to my test case, and if I will just do one thing, I'll just rewrite the same code but now with delay 0. So inside dot type, after entering my text, what I'll do, I will pass over here delay 0. So that ways it will enter your text in single go. It will not enter your text by one, and we can see this will improve the execution speed, right? So let's run our test case and see once again how quickly your test case is getting executed, right? So now my second test case will be executed, and over here I can see it's 0.05. Earlier it was 0.12. So 12 and 5, there is a difference. You know, there's a big difference between both, and we can see how our execution speed has actually execution speed is quite faster now, and the performance is also faster because the delay by using delay 0, it quickly entered your text. It does not enter one by one, and it will increase your efficiency. And in your project also, you will see the efficiency, the performance is increased by using delay 0. So guys, you need to know where you can use delay 0. It's not everywhere you can use delay 0. It's not required to use delay 0 everywhere. So in kind of scenarios where you have, you know, such kind of paragraph where we have to enter the text, in those cases you can use delay 0. Or let's say you are searching, you're working on e-commerce website and you're searching in a text box. So in that case, delay 0 will not help you, right? Because we are just entering one text. Maybe you're searching iPhone in a search bar. So in that kind of cases, delay 0 is not helpful. But in case of cases, let's say where you are entering a huge text, maybe let's say in the search box, if you are entering big text, so then you can use it. But generally, you can use it with paragraph or where you have big text to enter. But in cases where you have to enter only search only single word or two words, I would say don't use it because it does not add value over there. So you need to know the value addition of the command before using it, right? So I hope you like this quick tip, and you're liking this quick tip series where I'm sharing quick tips with you, which can actually improve the efficiency and increase your productivity in your project. Yeah. So please like and subscribe to the channel and share it with your friends, and don't forget to click on the bell icon so you don't miss any notification whenever there is any video uploaded, right?